My favorite superheroes are the ones that make sense to me. Iron Man is a genius engineer billionaire, and Batman is a ninja with gadgets and a grudge, also a billionaire. But even the more magical superheroes can make more sense than you think. So according to Stan Lee himself, Thor flies with a little thing called hammer propulsion.
The hammer goes flying off into space, but the thong is wrapped around Thor's wrist, so he goes with it.
So Thor flies by spinning his hammer around, letting it go, and holding on for the ride. Stan Lee says this is science, but how would it work? First, the hammer. Now, according to what canon you accept, Mjolnir here could weigh anywhere from 40 to a few billion pounds. So when Stan Lee says hammer propulsion, what I think he means is conservation of momentum. That is to say, an object with mass and velocity, or momentum, when it interacts with another object with mass and velocity, the total momentum between them is conserved. Thor could fly using this principle if he didn't lose an arm in the process. Using the conservation of momentum, let's put some numbers to what happens after Thor swings his hammer and lets go of it. Here's the equation we need. That is to say, the momentum of the hammer after Thor lets go of it has to equal the momentum of the hammer plus Thor after he grabs back onto it. Now, if Thor can throw his hammer, which can make itself arbitrarily heavy, at maybe 45 meters per second or 100 miles an hour, when he finally grabs back onto it with his 290 kilograms, his momentum basically won't change at all. It's an odd conclusion, but because Mjolnir can rapidly change its weight, Thor can fly at basically any speed he throws the hammer at. Another way to imagine this would be to imagine a bullet being fired into a block of wood. Even though the block is a lot more massive than the bullet, it's going to be carried along after the two impact. This is like Thor and his hammer. Of course, this conservation of momentum scenario only works if Mjolnir is ridiculously heavy. In one of my last Ask Kyle videos, I gave my favorite explanation for how this might be scientifically possible, so head over there if you want to learn more. How Thor flies actually makes a lot of scientific sense. Momentum is conserved, so grabbing onto something moving much faster than you are moving that is much heavier than you are, of course you're going to be pulled along for the ride. The real superhero stuff comes in when you are not getting your arm ripped off your body trying to do so. Even a super buff Chris Hemsworth would have a hard time grabbing onto what is effectively a moving freight train from a dead stop. Why? Because science! Want more science? Check out my last video on how the universe might contain TARDIS space. Make sure to like and subscribe right here for more videos, and if you have any comments or questions, make sure to hit me up in the comment section below. Thanks!